Throughout the year, the space, robotics and AI community come together across the country. Industry leaders, researchers, entrepreneurs and enthusiasts. These are all events organised and run by MySecurity Media's Australia in Space. The latest Sydney Space Industry Sundowner was hosted by the University of Sydney at their Australian Centre for Robotics.
Working closely with industry to help take those kind of research innovations.
Director of the centre, Professor Ian Manchester, presented a keynote speech where he took the opportunity to introduce the Arium Research Hub. Its aim is to transform the way assets and infrastructure are managed through the development of intelligent robotic systems. The majority of the evening was used for business pitches from startup companies that are part of the QuantumTX Incubator Program. For a decade now, QuantumTX has been a leading provider of these accelerator programs, assisting companies turn a novel product into a business that can be commercialized.
Specifically for this one, what we've done is we've taken a bunch of really great businesses and we've given them a 3 to 6 month training program to give them the tools to accelerate their business. And that will include meeting partners who might be investment providers or they might be customers that might use the products.
A significant partner of the initiative is Metz Ignited. Their CEO, Adrian Beer, attended the event to give a keynote speech.
Those little mining companies who love our dirt do spend a lot of money on research and innovation in Australia.
Several businesses pitched to the audience, including EXTAG, an asset management system company based in Perth, robotic systems, an engineering consultancy business, to this, the next evolution of human spaceflight. A spacesuit of the future designed and produced by Metakosmos.
So we're working on an integrated platform, which is essentially all the fabrics, materials, and a software that'll help you understand your performance inside the suit. So we're targeting the entire life cycle. So this isn't just about going into space, but you need to train to be able to perform in space. So our suits will help you throughout the process. So there's pre-flight training, and then the suits that actually go up into space, and then also coming back onto Earth, you need to be essentially custom to 1G conditions again. So the platform essentially takes you through that process and you could start monitoring your performance throughout the life cycle. So these suits would be commercially available, so you could be able to order one for yourself in the next 5 years and then maybe, you know, go to a nearby spaceport and shoot off into space.
Further pitches included an autonomous solar cleaning robot. The product was born after a WA mining company came to Innovative Energy Solutions with an issue. The dust on their solar panels was gathering up after only 2 to 3 days. This was affecting the efficiency of the panels, reducing productivity, and in turn, losing out on profit.
What we've done is we've created a high value, high quality solar panel cleaner, and we're manufacturing them in Perth. So Australian manufactured, specifically developed for the mining sector, a high quality product. And with that, we're actually now improving it, so it's actually more targeted towards the solar industry as a whole. So we're modifying it so we can clean solar farms and autonomously clean solar farms. And it's an exciting place to be because of the boom in solar energy, and we're really excited about where we're going.
The QuantumTX program has been invaluable to all those companies pitching, helping them accelerate their technologies to new heights. And those behind the program are sharing their experience and advice in a soon-to-be-launched book called Moonshot Applied, Sustaining Exceptional Innovation at Scale.
So Peter and I have been working for some time on a book on innovation, which basically encapsulates the experiences that we've had over the last decade working with startups, with large corporates and with government agencies. And I suppose what we felt was there are lots of books on creative thinking, and there are lots of books on learning from Elon Musk and great innovators. But there's not a lot of books about how do corporates successfully innovate repeatedly at scale. So we've interviewed a bunch of Australian businesses that we admire, as well as leading companies from around the world, such as Amazon and Google and so forth.
For more exposure to industry leaders in this field, captivating keynotes and opportunities in space and cross-sector technologies and innovation, take a look at the Indo-Pacific Space and Earth Conference that Australia in Space is hosting later this year in October. Go to spaceandearthconference.com. Laura Hawkins, Australia in Space TV, Sydney.